Now, we've got some Bluetooth devices, and we want to pair with those devices. By pairing, we're talking about doing some form of authentication so that the two ends are aware of the other and have done some sort of exchange of information so that both sides say, yes, it's okay that I know about the other one, and we can move forward. So let's talk about different ways of doing this pairing. Now, there are a handful of ways of doing pairing, actually, and some of it depends on the version of Bluetooth that is supported. Newer versions have better ways of doing this authentication than others do. So we've got some different pairing mechanisms. The first pairing mechanism is one that you will commonly see. It uses a PIN. Commonly, this PIN is something very simple like 000 or 1234, something like that. So when you attempt to pair, the device is going to prompt you to give what's essentially a pre-shared key. And this pre-shared key is just a PIN. So when the device that is trying to initiate the pairing sends off this pre-shared key or PIN, it's doing a form of authentication with the Bluetooth device that you're trying to pair with. Now, another one that you can do is secure simple pairing. This is something that's just a way of doing faster pairing, and often this is done because you may have a device that doesn't really have a lot of I/O capability. So for example, a computer mouse. When I want to pair with a computer mouse, I don't have a way of verifying on the mouse the PIN that I may be providing on the other side or vice versa. So the mouse can't spit out a PIN that I then type in on the other side, which may be common with other types of pairing. So that's actually the passkey entry mechanism. So if I'm using a keyboard, for example, my computer may actually spit out a passkey that may be a 6-digit numeric code, and I would type that in on the keyboard, and then the computer and the keyboard would actually pair. Now, when I go to a device here, so for example, let me pick the TV here, and I go to attempt to pair. This is using the secure simple pairing because I've got no way of actually typing anything in on the TV. Similarly, I may not have a really good way of doing any real authentication. So this is just using the very simplest of pairing modes. And you can see that it's actually paired right now. Now, the one thing that I don't actually see here is the capabilities that it has, and we will talk about profiles in a subsequent lesson. But as a general rule, you can't simply connect to any Bluetooth device that's available without doing some form of authentication. Now, if somebody happened to walk by me and they had just purchased a set of Bluetooth headphones, for example, and I were doing some Bluetooth scanning, I may be able to pair with those Bluetooth headphones if they're on and haven't been paired yet. I may be able to pair with those Bluetooth headphones before the actual owner pairs with them because, again, that's going to use the secure simple pairing without any I/O. So this is just going to do pairing. It's going to be very simple. And there's not going to be any exchange of information in between, which is what we just had with the TV. Now, I happen to know that the TV that I just paired with is in the other room from me, but I'm living in a densely populated area. There could be Bluetooth devices that are close by me that I may not actually have any physical access to, but I could actually pair with them anyway if somebody else hasn't actually done that, which again is why you want to shut off discoverable mode on your devices. Because if you do have a device that uses secure simple pairing and it's just sitting there waiting for somebody to connect to it, then that's a whole different problem because now you've suddenly got somebody else making use of this Bluetooth device and they may not be in a place that you can actually see them. They could be on another side of the wall, for instance, from you. They could be across a short span of grass in another building altogether, depending on where your devices actually were. Now, another type of pairing or authentication to talk about is this out-of-band pairing. Now, this happens with some types of devices. For example, a smartwatch might use out-of-band pairing. where you're using near-field communication in order to exchange some initial information in order to set up the Bluetooth pairing process. So we're using something that's outside of the Bluetooth spectrum or protocol in order to establish the Bluetooth connection. That's why we call it out of band. The band would be something that used Bluetooth itself and the Bluetooth frequencies and protocols. What we're using instead is near field communication or NFC. And you might get this with, as I said, a smartwatch, for example, where when you initially set it up, you touch your phone to the watch. There are a number of other devices that may do something similar. For example, the Sphero Orb toy that's a little robot, or Ollie, which is developed by the same people. Those use the same out-of-band pairing where you use NFC in order to do some initial exchange, and then they're connected using Bluetooth. So there are a handful of ways of doing this pairing. But what it comes down to is it's really doing some minimal amount of authentication to make sure that the two devices are really meant to pair with one another, at least within some limited specification.